A beautiful rendition of the national anthem from the South High Marching Band, and you see the lighted up S there in the background as the flag was raised. A great moment here on homecoming at South High, and here come the Rebels onto the field, ready to tangle, and if they win here, they will be 2-0 in the league and on the brink of a third straight SEYL title. South High comes in at 5-2 on the year. They are 1-0 in the league after beating Miramonte last week. That was on the road, a 63-14 victory for South. Week before that, they lost at West High, 17-14, so the Rebels had 5-2 losses to West and Cesar Chavez. As for Highland, they come in at just 2-4, but they played a pretty difficult schedule compared to the rest of the SEYL. Victories over Arvin and East High, and losses, all of them competitive, at Taft, which has only lost once, a 54-42 loss for Highland. Lost to Golden Valley at home 21-12, lost to Cesar Chavez at home 13-7, and lost last week at, or excuse me, 2 weeks ago at Independence 21-14. Highland had a bye week last week, so they play four consecutive league games to end the year. Next week, home against Miramonte. Of course, Miramonte and Foothill, both of them have only won one of their past 20 or so games. So we think Highland, North, and South will be at the top of this league race. And right now, South is clearly the favorite, and now a special moment unique to South High among Kern County teams. It's the pregame haka from the Rebels. A lot of fun here. They use a little dance. It's a traditional New Zealand rugby dance that the Rebels use to pump themselves up a little bit. This is pretty cool. And it includes vocals as well as the moves as we welcome listeners on ESPN Radio 1230 in Bakersfield. This is the South High football team's pregame haka dance. And the crowd responding to it, the Rebels wearing those beautiful baby blue uniforms. And as you might see if you're watching on Bakersfield.com, bear with us tonight because the navy numbers on the baby blue jerseys are a little bit difficult to see from our vantage point just to the left of the South High press box. So we will do our best with those numbers. Some of the guys we'll be talking about for the Rebels, the quarterback Aries Harris, his running back P.J. Jones, and another one, Devin McCord. South athletes all over the field, Lewis.
Well, we've seen South before, and we were very impressed with them last season. And you're right. You look at this team against Highland right now, they're a little bit deeper, a little bit bigger. But, you know, Highland's been competitive this season. The big issue with Highland's been injuries.
Yeah, absolutely, and the Scots still have quite the connection. The quarterback, Zeke Arambolo, is just a sophomore, but he has had a tremendous year so far, averaging 175 passing yards per game. His main target will be the senior, the 5'10" senior, Chance Cooper, who is over 300 yards receiving this year, and several other athletes for Highland as well, including Jacob Hargestam, the transfer from Bakersfield Christian, are among their leading receivers. Michael Gutierrez, in his second year at Highland, is really trying to take a step forward, and this breakthrough victory would certainly qualify as that tonight if Highland could get it.
I'll tell you what, South's got it dialed in when it comes to cool things. They got the haka, they got a really great band, they got great cheerleaders, they got this cool old truck, they got a victory bell, they got a drum line, they got this beautiful flag ceremony going on here. I mean, look at this place. Stadium is ripping. We're going to have to come do soccer here at some point, too.
Yeah, South High, of course, a great soccer team, two-time defending section champion, once in Division III and then this past season in Division II.
Remember last year, 2 years ago, they were just kind of so-so.
Yeah, and they came out of nowhere to win, and then last year a very good season, but this is not football, it is football, and South High will kick off to begin things. They have, among other things, a very good kicker, and he is a soccer player. That would be Jefferson Escobar, who has teed up the kick and is ready to play. Highland wearing its white jerseys, green numbers, green pants, and those dark green helmets that say the script Scots across them. And the Scots, as we mentioned, 43 years, zero league titles. They are the only Kern County football team that has not won a league title. Short pop-up kick from Escobar, but a flag flying before the kick, and looked like South may have jumped offside. Escobar still standing back by his tee at his own 40-yard line. That will cost the Rebels five.
That's a daunting stat, you know, talking about not winning a league title in 43 years.
Of course,
you would have figured he won a co-championship at some point in that that period.
For much of that history, Highland was in the same league as Bakersfield, and then Liberty when Liberty came on, and that makes things difficult. And originally in the same league as West High when they were a powerhouse, but the technicality there, Independence and Miramonte were in kind of a special league only for new schools their first season, and they split the league title. So Independence and Miramonte each get credit for one league title. Highland never has, a school that opened in 1971. So the Scots would love to win tonight. That would get them off to a great start as they go on a quest for that league championship. Michael Gutierrez is going to get in there, I have a feeling. Here's Escobar now from his own 35, and this time it's a deep kick. It'll be taken at about the 17-yard line, and taking it straight up the middle with a nice hole out close to the 40 is number 22. That's Jacob Hargestam, the transfer from BCHS. So Highland set up with great field position on the opening drive. Up at their own 42 is where they'll mark that ball. So great starting field position. South's calling card during this run of league championships has been its defense. And that's what they will count on tonight. The quarterback for Highland again is the sophomore Zeke Arambolo. And he takes a shotgun snap, looking to his left, now back to the right. Tries to dump it off, and it is incomplete. The pass hit the ground. Mikey Melendez, the slot back, had gone down to a knee to catch that anyway, so it's probably good for the Scots that it hit the turf. He would have been down right where he caught it, behind the line of scrimmage.
They spotted him generously back at the line of scrimmage.
Well, they called it incomplete, so that's a break for Highland.
Yeah, I think he made a catch on that.
Looked like he kind of made the catch and then almost dropped the ball, maybe on purpose. Play action pass now to the shotgun, and that pass nearly picked off. It was a swing pass out to the left, and one of the Rebels on that far side, and again, we apologize, it's difficult to see jersey numbers, just about jumped that, and it would have been six the other way. Now whoever that is going to do some push-ups to punish himself for not coming up with the pick.
Great penetration on the right side of the line there for South. South big across the front, three-man front.
So it is third down and 10 after two incomplete passes for Highland from their own 42. Arambolo back to pass, has some time looking to the left, and it's too high for a well-covered target over there.
Very well-covered there on the corner, on the edge.
Chance Cooper was the intended receiver, but three straight incompletions for Highland, and they are going to find out just how difficult it is to pass the ball against this defense. Fourth down and 10. That was Isaiah Carr breaking the pass up, I believe. Or excuse me, that was Isaiah Carr breaking that pass up. I believe he was the one who nearly jumped the previous pass. So Highland lines up to punt. Three plays, three incompletions, and 20 seconds into this game, Highland will punt. Chance Cooper, the punter, it's nearly blocked. He almost ran right into that block. A rugby-style kick taken at the 25, and good coverage downfield by Highland. South will get out to the 30. On the return by P.J. Jones. So the punt went to about the 26, a four-yard return by P.J. Jones. And with 11:33 to play here in the first quarter, South High gets its first possession, starting at its own 29-yard line. Centennial leading Garces 6-0 early. A Cesar De Leon to Cole Nelson, 25-yard touchdown pass for the Golden Hawks. A couple other games around the county starting late, including BHS Frontier and...
Got a delay here of some kind.
North and Miramonte, the other game in the SEYL, also starting late. Here we started on time, but after a quick three and out for Highland, we've got a delay. I don't think anybody called timeout.
I don't think it's a timeout. One of the... Was AD came out here, or what's going on?
Just 27 seconds into this one. We're still scoreless between Highland and Miramonte. This is BVarsity Game Night. Zach Ewing along with Lewis Amistoy. Happy to bring this one to you. Too bad our man Justin Roberts couldn't be with us tonight, but J-Rob and I teamed up many a time. I was gone the last 2 weeks. He's gone this week.
He joined us last night, though, for that terrible technical broadcast we had. Great match, though. I tell you what, Liberty and Centennial put on a show last night, and Liberty looked fantastic.
Score from the South Yosemite League, a Kobe Stancil one-yard touchdown run. Independence leads Golden Valley 7-0 midway through the first quarter. Games to watch around the section tonight, of course, Clovis West playing Buchanan. That game, a 14-0 advantage for Buchanan early. And that would be a second straight loss for Clovis West if they couldn't come back.
Not sure what the delay here is.
I wonder if it's some sort of equipment malfunction among radio equipment.
Yeah, we got the Highland guy next with his radio on. I don't know if South doesn't have their radios on. See someone down there on a radio.
All of the commotion is on the South High sideline.
Well, welcome to those of you who are joining us on 1230 ESPN Bakersfield. This is BVarsity Live. I'm Lewis Amistoy, joined by the one and only Zach Ewing, the guy who graduated from not only Stockdale High School, but BHS, South and Highland.
And don't forget Centennial and Liberty, man.
Centennial and Liberty.
I have graduated from every school in this city, unofficially. It's homecoming night. Seems like this is the time of year you catch a homecoming night every week, unless you go to the same school every week.
I like homecomings.
I know you do.
I kind of dropped the ball. I should have told all the photographers to get homecoming queens. I see my photographer down there right now. I may have to give him some work to do.
Well, dropped the ball 3 weeks ago at Centennial. We could have shot homecoming at Centennial.
I know. Well, you had to go get tri-tip or something like that. I got to give you credit. South High, their band is off the hook here. It's fantastic.
Well, they are very active. They're right below us to our left.
Let's get a shot of them while we figure out what's going on here.
The official's still huddling right at the line of scrimmage at the South High 29.
And the band continues to do a great job.
The break in the game is that we're waiting for a backup ambulance to come.
There's only one ambulance on site, and there needs to be two at all CIF-sanctioned events just in case one of the ambulances is called away. The other one is here in case of another injury, and I think I see one pulling up the street here on Plains Road.
Here comes one.
So they caught that about 30 seconds into the game, and they are waiting for the ambulance, and a Hall ambulance is indeed headed westbound on Plains Road. And I assume we'll be pulling into the... No, it just kept on going, Lewis. Maybe that wasn't our ambulance.
Well, there goes one up the other side. We probably just took its parking spot.
You would. Touchdown Frontier, a 7-0 lead for the Titans 3 minutes into that game. See if we can get the details there.
All right, so we are at 11:33 in this game. South forced a punt from Highland on a three and out. They have the ball at their own 29-yard line here, and we're waiting for an ambulance to show up here at beautiful South High School. This is a great facility. Be even better with an all-weather track.
A 67-yard touchdown drive for Frontier, capped by a 5-yard run by Marcus Prado. Just 2:46 into the game, Frontier leads Bakersfield 7-0. If Frontier wins that, you're going to be looking at possibly Liberty and Centennial as the only undefeated teams left in the SWIL. They play in 2 weeks, I believe, at Centennial.
This is one of those like high school facilities you can kind of like, you can kind of see some potential here.
Well, you know, you mentioned that it would be a lot of fun to hold a big track meet here.
Yeah, I mean, you could put it's kind of tight. But it's a big track. It's a dirt track. It's a beautiful-looking dirt track, actually.
Get some other scores for you around the section. We mentioned this one. End of a quarter now. Buchanan 14, Clovis West nothing. Lemoore 14, Mount Whitney nothing. Another ranked team. Edison and Sanger just now kicking off. That's a big game in the County Metro Athletic Conference. Bakersfield Christian has homecoming tonight against Shafter. What a roll they're on. And they have yet to kick off. Independence 7, Golden Valley nothing. You mentioned Frontier 7-0 over BHS. UNLV 7, Fresno State nothing. Boy, the Bulldogs are in a funk. And quick score update. The game just started in a double reverse touchdown pass for Bakersfield Christian. They lead Shafter 7-0.
Big win for BCHS last week. They had quite the little party going on down there in the end zone with the you see this action over here, Zach? You got all these parents or faculty members over here. I don't know if you can see it or not. You're small and little. But look at this action here.
It's like a suite down there on the field.
There's somebody having nachos. Somebody on the phone. There's some big 32-ounce drinks. There's someone on the blanket. They got a barbecue down there, Zach. There's a barbecue down there.
Why aren't we broadcasting from down there?
They got food down there, the whole thing. That's quite a deal. They got to figure it out at South High School.
Yeah, this is a good atmosphere. The only thing missing is an ambulance. And we saw two drive by and just keep right on going, so they must not have been the ones radioed here. It wasn't like they had their lights on or anything.
Right.
I wonder, do they have to enter from the other side of the school? Maybe those ambulances were driving around the school. Even then, they should be here any second. The team's trying to stay warm, really just kind of going through pregame routines, the South High offense. You see Aries Harris out there taking some snaps. He's the South High quarterback. One of these weeks, I'll get to write a game story where I actually have some time to go down and talk to coaches. I thought it would be this week, but we are stuck in an ambulance delay. And that is not nearly as serious as it sounds.
I've seen enough of that already this season, you know, the BC situation.
Yep. How about the Arena Bowl last year, too?
Oh, my God, that was awful. All right, they're ready to do this game now.
Well, I still don't see an ambulance. But they've called the players back onto the field, so it must be here somewhere. No score, Highland and South. Scott's got the ball first. They went three and out very quickly on three incomplete passes. And they have punted the ball away. South High with its first possession now from its own 29-yard line. 11:33 to play, first quarter. And the Rebels' quarterback is number 9, Aries Harris. Number 8, excuse me, Aries Harris. See number 14, P.J. Jones. Number 20, Devin McCord with him in the backfield. And the Rebels offense now approaching the line of scrimmage, and we are ready for some action again. No score, Highland and South, a key Southeast Yosemite League game here. And there is Aries Harris. It's McCord right next to him. P.J. Jones, I believe that is behind him. Again, very difficult to see the jersey numbers for South High. We'll do our best here. A pitch to Jones, and he's going to throw. He's got a man wide open, and it's through the fingertips of the intended receiver.
He was right on that.
Down at about the 20-yard line, that would have been a 71-yard touchdown pass. And it was a pretty good throw by P.J. Jones.
Absolutely. There's our ambulance.
Led him just about half a yard too far there.
I have a theory that the Hall ambulances have probably the most sirens on them of any ambulance service in the United States.
I saw one coming down Airport Drive today, and nobody's getting out of the way of it. And, man, that driver just laid
that
on the horn.
Drives me crazy when people don't do that. We'll run to the right side, Zach.
A spin by Devin McCord, but he's still bottled up by the Highland defense, and he got maybe 3 yards before he was driven back.
Run by number 14, Jones.
Excuse me, that was P.J. Jones with the run. Jones gets about three out to the 32, so it'll be third down and 7. First drive of the game for the South High Rebels after Highland went three and out on its first possession. Just over a minute into this game, if you're just joining us here on BVarsity Game Night, we had a short delay 30 seconds into the game to wait for an ambulance to arrive, and the ambulance is here, so we're playing again. South High facing a 3rd and 7, a lopsided formation, everybody to the left, and that's the way they'll pitch it, and
a tackle.
Beautiful tackle made
18
by number 67.
18 and 57 on the tackles there, Zach. 18 made the stop,
yeah.
And then 57 with the final.
Carlo Baumann, 57 with the big hit, and 18 is Chance Cooper. So P.J. Jones just missed on the bomb on a halfback pass, And then he runs twice and nets just 1 yard. That was a loss of two there. And South High also goes three and out and will have to punt the ball away.
Cooper might be playing with a broken hand, too, of some kind.
Yeah, he's got a cast on there, doesn't he?
Yeah. Going to back up South now.
Got some sort of a substitution foul on South. And so that will push them back to the 25, and it'll be fourth and 14 there. So here comes the punt. It's a wobbly kick. It's going to bounce shy of midfield and take a short South High bounce and roll to the Highland 47 where it's downed. And so great field position again for the Scots. They started their first drive at their own 42. This is even better. Aries Harris was the punter. A 28-yard punt there with no return with 9:56 to play. First quarter still scoreless. Highland taking over at its own 47-yard line. We have 1 yard of total offense in this game. It belongs to South.
Hey, via Instagram right now, the Highland people are predicting a bloodbath on the soccer pitch between these two teams. That should be interesting.
Wow. Touchdown Centennial, 12-0 Golden Hawks over Garces.
Offsides.
Flag flying, and I don't know if that was offsides or if all the motion by the South High defense made a Highland lineman jump.
I think South jumped on that one.
You know, it is Highland they're going to call that on. And almost BHS style, some of those South High linebackers were kind of jumping and dancing around that defensive lineman, and it made one of the Highland linemen jump. And so it'll be first and 15 back at the 42. Still good field position for the Scots. Zeke Arambolo back there. He was 0 for 3 on the first possession.
I'm still permanently traumatized by last week's 303-yard penalty game.
In the shotgun, Arambolo's going to roll to his right.
Bubble.
He's looking. He's under pressure, and he's tripped up and sacked.
Defensive play there by number 2 of South.
And that is Isaiah Carr making that play. He came a long way to make that sack. It's a loss of 7.
Well, he was just disruptive on the line, coming on that right side.
All the way back at the 35, it's second down and 22 now for Highland. So they are way behind the sticks. Need to get all the way up to the South 43 for a first down here. They've got two plays to do it. In the shotgun, a handoff, fake handoff, and a play action pass dumped and completed to the right side. And a little bit of running room, a flag coming in. Out past the 45.
We a hold back here.
Goes Bryson McCathren caught that pass, but I think you're right, Lewis. I think this is going to come back. McCathren, just a little slot back there, made the catch just shy of the 40 and rumbled out to about the 46, but it will be a holding call against Highland. We'll see. I think they marked that hold. The flag was down at the 40. We'll see where they count it from.
Vance Palm's texting us something. I'm not sure what it is. I got to bend over to find the read the text. I'm kind of elderly. We don't have our most pristine setup here, although we might have the greatest internet connection here that we've had so far.
I'm telling you, it's the new deal, man. This is FDR construction here. So the penalty marked at the 40. So it's going to be
East High's FDR construction. This is like
Eisenhower era.
I think it's more like Johnson. Although Bakersfield Life editor Olivia Garcia went here, so it's probably built in the late 50s, early 60s.
Second down and 27 after the penalty. The lefty Arambolo on a screen pass completes it. Ooh. And Rodney Roden made the catch, and he gets about 10 yards out to the 40. So it'll be third down and long from there. So Roden with really the first positive play offensively for Highland of the game.
I think we've had 3 South High grads work at the Bakersfield, California.
But even with that 10-yard completion, it's third down and 17 from the 40. Hand off to Cooper on a sweep. He's looking left, looking for some room. Flag coming in. There was a helmet that came off. And then Cooper, as you said, hit hard at about the 42.
Number 60 of Highland's going to come out of the game.
Well, it is going to be fourth down pending the penalty here. Let's see what it is. It is a face mask against South.
Wow.
And it's a personal foul variety, so that's a 15-yard penalty. Now,
does that mean that 60 has to come out of the game then or not?
You know, in college he would. I don't know about the high school rule. But I do know in high school a personal foul penalty is not an automatic first down.
It is
going to be third and a yard after a gain of one on that play and the 15-yard face mask penalty. Third and 17 becomes third and one up at the South 44. So a big penalty there against the Rebels. But right now, Highland struggle getting anything. They need to get a yard. Just over 8 minutes to play first quarter in a scoreless game here at South High.
So make sure to make some noise for your Rebels.
Highland approaches the ball, a bunch formation. Nobody split wide. Three backs behind Arambolo, and Arambolo did an unbelievable hard count there and drew about four South defenders offside.
They got a quarterback change, 17. They're going to call it on Highland.
Yep, you're right. They are going to call it on Highland. Somebody moved, I guess. That was Mikey Melendez, who came in, just to try the hard count, but one of his own men jumped. So that's going to make, it was third and 17, then third and one, and now back to the 49, it's third and six. I understand doing that on fourth down. On third and one, don't you just try to get the first down without getting too tricky? Highland just across midfield. They've enjoyed good field position in this first quarter, but the Scots have not cashed in yet. So Arambolo back at quarterback, play action fake, lefty throws, and he was looking for Melendez, but Melendez had not turned around. Isaiah Carr was turned around for South, and Arambolo probably lucky.
Arambolo's
Carr didn't have a chance.
The problem right now is he's just got too much pressure coming from that defensive line.
And his response to that has been to force balls into pressure.
They're going to have to punt it away.
So a sack on first down after a penalty. Highland got it to a point of third and one because of a face mask penalty against South, but still going to have to punt. Chance Cooper, the punter. He's backing up now to about his own 42-yard line. Back to return is P.J. Jones. Another rugby-style kick trying to corner it away from Jones, and Jones gets dangerously close to that ball, nearly touched it, and it is going to bounce down to the 1 yard line where it is down by Peter Laird. So a beautiful kick there by Chance Cooper. P.J. Jones tried to make an awkward catch, then thought better of it and let it bounce, and it dies at the 1 yard line. So Highland has not done anything offensively, but they have won the field position battle thus far. South backed up at its own one with 7:15 to play in the first quarter. South huddling all the way at the back of its own end zone.
One of the challenges of shooting in this stadium, though, are the light standards. They're on the field, so we'll be having an obstructed view here on Bakersfield.com. That might be a safety.
That might be a safety. Did he get out of the end zone?
Yep.
Yes.
Safety.
It is a safety.
Well, Highland's defense is playing well right now, I tell you what.
P.J. Jones was stuffed short of the line of scrimmage. And it is a safety and a 2-0 lead for Highland. 7:02 to play in the first quarter. And the defenses have scored the first points here. After the beautiful punt by Chance Cooper. It was down at the 1 yard line by Peter Laird. What a great name for a Scotsman, Laird. And Highland's defense tackles P.J. Jones in the end zone. And it's 2-0 Scots. So now we'll see a free kick from the 20 yard line for the Rebels. They give up the 2 points and have to give the ball back.
Shout out to Sophia, Victoria, Augie, and Stephanie. Love you guys.
Quite a turn of events here. Highland's offense has done nothing.
On another note, make sure to make your way over to the snack shop. Whatever food or refreshments you want.
7:02 to go here in the first quarter from South High School, and Highland leading 2-0.
There's your football reference.
Yep.
So now the free kick from the 20-yard line. They've got the ball teed up. It's South's choice here. They can punt this ball. But they decide to kick it off. And Escobar's kick,
he belted that. Holy
is
smokes.
Taken at the 26 by Hargestam. And Hargestam, or actually this is number 22, excuse me. Yeah, that's Hargestam. And Hargiston knifes his way up past the 45. So Highland gets the 2 points and then gets great field position again. They're on their own 46. They've started.
Kicked that ball 54 yards into the air.
They've started their drives at the 42, the 47, and the 46 now have the Highland Scots, and they lead 2-0. Haven't done much on offense. We haven't seen a first down in this game. But the Scots cashing in on great field position with that safety. Arambolo in the shotgun. He's a lefty. He hands off on a little turnaround play to Chance Cooper, who darts up the middle. Not much room there, though. The South linebackers rallying to the cause, and Cooper maybe a yard.
Number 18, Cooper with the run. Tackled by number 17.
Almost seems Highland is shy to try a traditional running play. Tried a lot of sweeps and different misdirections and things. Now they've used play-action fakes to traditional running plays, but that doesn't do you a whole lot of good if you're never actually going to run the ball. Second down and 9. Another fake handoff over the middle. It's complete to Cooper for a first down into South High territory at the 42. A South High Rebel goes down.
Cooper's taking some shots so far here early on. 6:20 to go, first quarter.
First downfield pass complete for Highland.
Nice little call, little screen pass.
Goes for 10 yards and a first down on second and 9 at the South 43. So Highland leading 2-0 midway through this first quarter. And the Scots on the march at the South 43 with a first down. Another play action. Arambolo downfield. Looked like it could have been a defensive holding call.
Yeah,
it falls incomplete, and they called it. That ball may not have been catchable for a pass interference, but that looked like a defensive hold even before the ball was released by Arambolo. The receiver was Hargiston. We have two flags actually on the field, one closer to the line of scrimmage.
Maybe offsetting.
Now Highland's walking backwards here. Let's see what the calls are. First one's an illegal shift against Highland. And then we have pass interference against South. So the penalty's offset, and we will replay first and 10. 6:13 to play first quarter. Highland 2, South 0.
What a gorgeous night this ended up being.
It really is. We've got just a sliver of moon behind us.
And since the lights are in front of us, the bugs are in front of us.
October, just about the best month for Bakersfield weather, I think. Arambolo over the middle again. Sliding catch,
nice catch
is made by number 3, Bo Brannon. And Bo Brannon, the younger brother of 3-year starter at quarterback for Highland, Breaker Brannon. Nice catch there at the 29. A gain of 14. First down Highland inside the 30. Arambolo sends a man in motion. He's in the shotgun. Back to pass. The southpaw looking. He's flushed out of the pocket. Now he's going to try to run, and he's spun down by number 63, I believe. Jesus Robledo. And so Arambolo is sacked. It looked like he had some running room, but Robledo got him for a 4-yard loss. Second sack of the night for the South High defense. Second down and 14, back at the 33.
That's a little inside give, and number 17 breaks it up to the middle and brought down right about the 30-yard line.
That's Mikey Melendez.
Run by number 17, Melendez.
And gets back up to the almost the original line of scrimmage. It'll be a third and long.
So third down, and we'll call it 10. It's just a little bit more than the original line to gain. Scott's probably not quite in field goal range yet, so the question is, do you go for the first down? Do you maybe try to pick up 5-7 yards to get your kicker into field goal range? Just inside the 30-yard line is where the ball's spotted, third and 10. Scott's lead South 2-0, and we've got a timeout called here by Highland. They want to talk about this. So that gives us a chance to reset things with 4:43 to play in the first quarter. Highland on this drive a couple of downfield passing completions, but right now it's their special teams and defense that has them out front 2-0. A Chance Cooper punt that went 48 yards and died at the South High 1 yard line. That led to a safety. The Highland defense stuffing PJ Jones behind the goal line and making it 2-0 Highland. And they have taken the free kick and are now at the South High 30,
some notes,
facing a 3rd and 10.
Some notes from Vance Palm. Famous Rebel alumni, IndyCar legend Rick Mears, and the Rebel Regiment Band and Color Guard under the direction of Gene Johnson Hurry.
How about former Stockdale Athletic Director Mark Hance played here? I believe he played on South High's team that reached the big school section championship in the 60s. A lot of South High alumni around town. Arambolo back to pass on 3rd and 10 out of the timeout. He's got a man open, but he overshot him. Cooper was streaking open down the left sideline. But Arambolo was off target with the throw. It sailed way out of bounds, and so it will be 4th down. Well, you make the call. I thought they were about to call your car there, by the way, in the parking lot.
Lights are on.
It's not you. It's not you. Arambolo now 4 of 9 passing.
It's my daughter's car we're driving. If it got towed, I guess it'd be okay.
That was a missed opportunity.
That was a missed opportunity.
For Highland, a wide open receiver.
They're going to try a field goal. Wow.
So this is a long field goal.
This is 46 yards.
The holder, number 12, Isaac Garcia. The kicker is Chance Cooper. And that thing just kind of bounced and burned some worms, and it's going to be returned from the goal line now. And look out with some room to run at the 50, the 40, inside the 30, and running away from the defense for a 100-yard return. It's Michael Perez.
Nope.
And there are flags on the field. And I'm sorry, that is PJ Jones with the return, number 14. The flag is all the way down here inside the 30, so there may have been a hold
There's
during
a flag
the return.
At the 25.
Oh, there are two flags on the field. That decision to kick the field goal absolutely backfired in Highland's face. P.J. Jones back there takes the ball at the goal line and went 100 yards the other way, but it's not going to count, we don't think.
Penalty flags at the 25. Penalty flags at the penalty flag at the 28. One in South territory, one in Highland territory.
The white hat talks to one referee on the left side of the field as we're looking at it. Now he's jogging to the other side of the field to talk with two other referees. And now he's talking to them to find out what this flag's all about. So we'll settle this. It's going to be South High ball either way. That field goal never had a chance. Chance Cooper just bounced it down to the goal line. It was about a 48-yard field goal.
Don't forget to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, BVarsity Live.
A block in the back against South. And I think this one's called all the way back near the line of scrimmage.
Wow.
And then a dead ball personal foul against Highland.
Wow.
And now a dead ball personal foul against South. So 3 fouls on the play, 2 of them against South. The personal fouls will upset. The personal fouls offset, and they will enforce the block in the back, it looks like. And that happened way back at the South High 30-yard line. So South will get the ball, but they're not going to get the touchdown out of it. I don't think I've ever – that was like the Auburn-Alabama game from a couple of years ago where Auburn returned the missed field goal all the way for a touchdown. But it doesn't count.
Jeff Evans reporting that Frontier up 14-7 over BHS into the first quarter.
So a half the distance of the goal penalty is going to set South up at its own 15. 4:22 to go. We've had an eventful 2-0 game so far. That goes in the books as a 15-yard penalty, folks, but really that's an 85-yard penalty because P.J. Jones took it to the house from the goal line.
Thanks for all you do for our kids. And another one for Mr. Allen.
So now Aries Harris, his third drive, although the last one lasted just one play. It was a handoff to P.J. Jones. He was tackled in the end zone. Line of scrimmage was the 1 yard line, and that created the safety that is the only score so far tonight. Highland leading South 2-0, 4:22 to play in the first quarter. Harris now in the shotgun. That's Jones next to him. He's going to throw, and he's got a man open on the far side. It's complete for a first down.
20 for Highland there on the tackle.
Up close to the 27-yard line.
Take up about 11 yards on that play.
Let's put it right at the 25-yard line, right across the 25, the 26.
And I got to say, I have no idea who caught that ball. The number's way too hard to read in this light.
So they have the big monitor up here. I'll try to keep an eye on it for you.
But it is a gain of 11 and a first down.
It's too dark for me to read the rosters, though. Kind of in a bad spot in some ways. Great spot, but bad spot.
So first down at the 26. Harris in the shotgun. Backs up. Into traffic, and it's broken up. Gabriel Johnson for Highland got a hand on it the last minute. Incomplete.
Intended for number 22. That's hard to read even in a
Jamie Gonzalez.
That's hard to read even in a zoom.
I don't think these teams, Frontier's got uniforms like that too. They don't think about the point of jersey numbers is for people to be able to see who it is. And if you make them hard to read, boy.
Especially when you're as blind as we are.
Defeats the purpose, yeah, and in this lighting as well. We'll stop complaining now. Second down and 10. We know that's Aries Harris, and he hands off here to P.J. Jones. And again, the Scots defense rallying to the cause. A fumble nearly scooped up by Highland. I think that was Hargiston had a chance to scoop and score, but he dropped it. The ball still loose at the 15. Highland saying they have it, waiting on a signal from the referees. Clock still running. It's South High football. Keeps it. They lost about 11 yards on the play because Hargiston almost shoveled that ball backwards as he was trying to scoop and score, but he couldn't come up with it cleanly. So that could have been disaster for South. Instead, it's a fumble.
Chance Cooper was there on the strip. I think 63 might have made the initial contact there for Highland.
Highland's run defense has been just exquisite so far. And third down and 21 now for South. Aries Harris scrambling. Looking deep and was flattened.
What a...
By number 57,
yeah.
Carlo Balmont. And P.J. Jones,
in a hurry.
Aries Harris had a man open downfield, but in waiting for him to pop open, he gave Balmont time to pancake him back there at the 10-yard line.
Boy, Highland is just playing tough defensively right now. They're flying around, making things happen. It's a nice battle up front, too. I wish I could, if you like to isolate on defense right now, on the good battle going on up front. It's a pretty good one. Oh, they're going to knock the punter loose.
No flag, it doesn't look like.
There's a flag down.
There is, and Hargiston takes it at the 41, and he may take it all the way back up the left sideline. He is into the end zone for a touchdown.
And that's coming back, though.
And unbelievable, Highland hit the punter. A 46-yard punt return for a touchdown by Hargiston is going to be nullified by a roughing the kicker penalty, we think. These teams can't stay out of their own way right now. And that is exactly what it is, a roughing the kicker personal foul penalty. But 15 yards will not mean a first down for South. Put the ball up at the 26.
That flag will erase the punt return.
So it's 4th and 10 now, back at the original line of scrimmage. But
it's kind of interesting because there looked like there was a block in the back on the Highland side to clear the way for that one. But
I guess that personal foul is an automatic first down. I'm confused as to why that is and the other one wasn't. But
so it's 15 yards and an automatic first down. They moved the sticks backwards, right? Because it wasn't. It's almost like a negative gain on that, or negative.
It was just about right where the original line was. So it's at the 26, maybe move them back half a yard.
149.
So fresh chance for South.
There's some movement there. I'm surprised.
Another fumble, and the ball is loose again.
That's going to be Highlands.
It was a sweep with Micah Spinella coming across the line of scrimmage, and South got it back again.
They call second down. Number 14 on the recovery for South.
So that's P.J. Jones. Spinella fumbled and lost a yard. South's got to be careful here. They've really been on the brink of disaster a couple of times.
South seems just really rattled right now.
They are definitely out of sorts. 1:18 to play and counting in the first quarter. It's Highland 2, South nothing here on BVarsity Game Night. Glad you could be with us. Aries Harris, South quarterback, in the shotgun. Man goes in motion. It's a handoff here for Devin McCord, and he is swallowed up as he tries to stretch that play out. Another loss on the play.
I tell you what, 57 for Highland is playing a lights-out game defensively. He's been there every single time. Unbelievable.
So Devin McCord with his first carry of the night is a loss of 2. And so after the roughing the punter penalty bailed South's offense out, they're back in the third and long, third and 13 here.
This is why I like these kind of games, because I can come out to these games and I can watch a kid and then I can argue with you and Trevor later when we do all area.
There you go. You can't base it on one game.
I can.
Well,
I will.
You try. Flag down, pre-snap.
South.
I think you bring the flags. You had them last week at Stockdale, and you've got them again here. A false start against South will cost the Rebels 5 more yards.
I'm not saying anything I don't necessarily disagree with here.
Are you saying last week you were?
I vociferously disagreed with one element of that game last week. Could have been another movement there. Harris keeps the ball on a keeper.
Harris will keep it. And on third and long, he's not going to get much. He got maybe 5-6 yards there, but it was third and 18.
Number 8, Harris keeps the ball.
So he gets out to the 25. We'll give him 7 yards on the play, but it'll be fourth and 11.
Punt that into the first quarter.
And that is the end of the first quarter. So at the end of a quarter on BVarsity Live, Highland leading South 2-0. We talked a lot about